children.
Good morning, ma'am.
In the previous module, what we discussed?
Rock cycle and minerals.
Very good. In the rock cycle, rocks are forming in a cyclic manner. From one form of rock to another form. They are interrelated. How they are interrelated? From the igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks are forming. From the sedimentary rocks and igneous rocks, metamorphic rocks are forming. From the metamorphic and the sedimentary, with the great pressure and heat, again it is forming as a lava. From the lava, igneous rocks. Like it is in a cyclic manner and they are interrelated, so rock cycle is forming. Next one is minerals. Yesterday we discussed about the minerals also. These are the natural substances. Naturally they are occurring on the layers of the earth. These minerals are divided into two types. Metallic minerals and non-metallic minerals. Metallic means they consist of the one or two metals. Suppose example iron. Yesterday we discussed now iron, gold,
copper,
silver. These come under the metallic minerals. These metallic minerals, they are the solid. They are solid and shiny surface. They have shiny surface. I told yesterday, suppose this gold is there. See how this is shining. It has the shiny, hard and shiny surface. Silver also shiny, copper, iron. Iron is very hard. So from the earth, we are taking these minerals. They are in the solid form. We are making into different forms. Suppose that solid is there, iron is there. We are making into sheets, no? Thin sheets, like this small sheets we are making. We are making wires also and bars also. Suppose window is there. In window we can see bars, no? Well, like that, from the iron, with the high temperature, we can melt as a liquid form. Then they will melt the bars. Suppose if we will take the copper. Anytime you saw electrical wire?
Yes, ma'am.
I see here I will show you one electrical wire is there. This electrical wire. Inside what you can see?
Copper wire?
Yeah, copper wire. So here the copper is melted as a small thin wires. So these metallic minerals, they are a solid shiny surface. They will, with the high temperature, they melt as a, it may be thin sheets, they will made it. Otherwise, wise they will made it. Okay, these are the metallic. Next one, non-metallic. Suppose yesterday I told the example salt. Is it a metallic or non-metallic?
Non-metallic.
Non-metallic. It consists of the chemical composition. What is the formula, chemical formula of salt?
NaCl.
NaCl. Here Na means?
Sodium.
Sodium. Cl means?
Chlorine.
Chlorine. So naturally they form from the ocean water. This is non-metallic. And we discuss about the uses of the minerals also. They are using in the industries, iron industry we discussed yesterday, steel, iron and steel, copper also using in the industries. Okay, different industries they are using. And yesterday we discussed about, I told them, minerals they are using in the medicine also. Pharmaceuticals also used. I brought medicines also. See these medicines, tablets I brought. This is an iron tablet. For what we'll take this iron tablet?
For iron deficiency.
Iron deficiency, if the blood, lack of the deficiency of the blood, we'll take the iron. This is the medicine. Otherwise, from the natural, how will you take iron supplementary? This is medicine you are taking, tablet form. Naturally, how you can take?
Spinach.
Spinach. Leafy vegetables. All leafy vegetables, it contains the iron. And milk, egg also we can take. Suppose calcium, I told yesterday calcium also, no? Calcium tablets. Calcium tablets. So, this is one more tablet. So, from minerals, they are making the tablets also in the pharmaceutical companies. Okay. So, instead of this medicine, we can take naturally. Calcium, we can drink more milk, we can take the carrot also, we get natural, egg also, calcium, which are there natural substances, calcium, we can take instead of the medicine, iron also supplementary, instead of the supplementary, naturally we can take, it give the resistance to our body. Yesterday this all discussed in the previous module. Today we will see interesting topic. This is a very very interesting topic. Have you ever wondered what you see in the below of the earth? This is the surface. surface of the earth. It is very wonder because these layers are moving. The layers are moving under the crust. Crust is a solid layer. Crust is a solid layer. And the solid layer, the liquids are also there. Okay. So now we see the layers of the earth. Already we discussed layers of the earth. In the previous modules, we discussed about the layers of the earth. So here the layers of the earth based on composition of minerals. Based on composition of minerals. Next one, based on the mechanical process. Based on the mechanical process. So the layers of the earth is divided into two types. One is the based on the composition of the minerals. Next one is the based on the mechanical process. Means here the movement of the earth. The movement of the earth means here layers. The movements in the layers. The movements in the layers. That is called the mechanical movement. So in the previous module already we discussed the composition of the minerals. Based on the composition of the minerals, how the earth layers are divided. Crust, mantle, core. Crust, mantle, core. Already we discussed about the crust. See here, the crust is divided into two layers. So the crust mainly, first one is the, this is the oceanic crust. Next one, this is the continental crust. Already we discussed this one. Next one here, oceanic crust. Only one layer is there. Only one layer. In the continental crust, two layers are there. Upper layer, lower layer. In this, it consists of the rocks. When we discussed about the rocks, in detail, already we discussed about this one, layers of the crust. Today we see the mantle. We will discuss already crust over in the previous module when we are discussing about the rocks. Because this crust is made large part of the rocks, percentage, large percentage of the rocks we can see in the crust only. Large percentage of the rocks we can see in the crust. Already we discussed what type of rocks. Hard rocks, soft rocks, where the hard rocks are available in upper layer of the crust, where the soft rocks are available in lower layer of the crust. Already we discussed. Today we see the mantle and the core in detail we'll discuss. Now this mantle, it is below the crust. The mantle is below the crust. The mantle is divided into two layers. Here in the mantle, two layers are there. Upper mantle, lower mantle. We see in the picture here. See next one, below the crust. This is the crust. Below the crust, this is the mantle. This portion is called mantle. Again, this mantle is divided here. This one, this part is upper mantle. This part is upper mantle, this part. Next, this part is called lower mantle. This is the lower mantle. Now, mantle is divided into how many layers, ma?
Two layers.
Two layers. What are the two layers?
Upper mantle and lower mantle.
Upper mantle and
lower mantle.
This mantle, that here, see. The thickness of the mantle is 2900 kilometers. Already we discuss here. Oceanic crust is average is thickness is 5. Means here 5 to 10 kilometers. Some places 5 you can see, some places 7, 8. Average is 5. Average is 5. Next one, continental crust also we discuss. Here it is average is 35. Means 10 to 75 is there. Some places. Suppose mountains. See here this mountains. The thickness is more. Mountains thickness is more. Suppose this is the plain area. The thickness is less. Like if you will take average, it is 10 to 75. Some places less, some places more. If you can take, that is the 35 is the average. 35 kilometers. The thickness of the oceanic
crust.
Continental crust. Now we will see the mantle. We are saying the total thickness of the mantle from here to here. That is 2900 kilometers. Now we see upper mantle. Upper mantle 300 kilometers. It occupies that is thickness of 300 kilometers. Next one is the lower mantle. Next one is occupied by the lower mantle. Next one we can see the core. Third layer is Already we know the minerals what is available in the oceanic continental crust and the oceanic crust. So here in the continental crust it is available silicon and Al. SiAl means silicon and aluminium. And the lower layer it is available SiAm, silicon magnesium. Here silicon magnesium, here silicon aluminium. Now here in the mantle what the minerals are available means silicon. Here the minerals are available silicon, aluminium. Here also aluminium is available, iron is available. Next magnesium also available. Here also magnesium also available. Next one, lower mantle also it is. So here magma we can see more. In the upper mantle it is a semi solid. Upper mantle is semi solid. In the lower mantle we can see the magma. We know already magma means a liquid.
Yes.
Liquid. Okay. So here also same minerals we can see in the lower mantle also. Next below the mantle the layer is called crust. This layer is called core. Below the mantle this layer is called core. This core also divided into two. One is the outer core. This is outer core. This is the inner core. This core the thickness of the core is 3500 kilometers. The thickness of the core is 3500 kilometers. So here in the inner core and outer core, suppose if you see the outer core, we can see here liquid form. Liquid you can see. But in the inner core, when we are coming down, we can see the solid particles. Solid particles. Here temperature also more. In this mantle, the temperature is 3000 nearly 500 degrees. When we come to here, nearly 5000 to 6000. When we are going down, already I told in the previous module, when we are going down, the temperature will
increase.
The temperature will increase. When we are going upwards, the temperature is
decreases.
When we are going upwards, the temperature is
decreases.
When we are going downward, the temperature is
increasing.
Increase. Already in the previous module we discussed this one. That's why in the summer where we go?
Hill station.
While we are going upward the temperature is decreases. While we are going inside the temperature is increases. This is called normal lapse rate. Normal lapse rate. Okay. Now we'll see here this is the composition of wall based on the composition of the minerals. Based on the composition of the minerals, the layers of earth divided into crust, mantle, core. Again, in the crust, two layers are there, upper crust, lower crust. Next one, in the mantle, upper mantle, lower mantle. Next, in the core, upper core, outer core, or inner core. Outer core or inner core. Now, we see the layers of earth based on the mechanical, physical behavior. Physical behavior means movement. Movement of the layers. Movement of the layers. Can you see movement of the layers?
No, ma'am.
Can you feel?
No, ma'am.
No, we cannot. Because they move very slowly. The layers in the liquid form slow. They move very slowly. We cannot feel that movement. So here, on the basis of the mechanical, based on the movement, the layers of the earth divided into five types. They are divided into how many?
Five.
One is the lithosphere. One is the lithosphere. Next one is the asthenosphere. Next one is the mesosphere. Next one is the outer core. Next one is the inner core. This outer core, inner core are same. Already we discussed what is there in the core. That core only. Outer core, inner core. Next, first three we see lithosphere. Litho means, what is the meaning of litho?
Living.
Litho means stones. Litho means
stones.
So, it is a Greek word. Litho means stone. Means the crust is called lithosphere. The crust is called solid, semi solid. So here in the lithosphere, this layer consists of crust plus upper mantle till here. Till here. This layer is called lithosphere. This layer is called lithosphere. It is a rigid. It is a very rigid and a solid. It is very solid. Next one you will see now. Next, what is the next layer?
Asthenosphere.
Asthenosphere. So it consists of, here already I told you, mantle is divided into upper mantle, lower mantle. Upper mantle, lower mantle. So here, inner layer of the upper mantle. Inner layer of the upper mantle. From there to down. Lower level of the mantle. It consists. Next one, mesosphere. Mesosphere enter in the lower mantle. Mesosphere enter in the lower mantle. Next one, outer core, inner core already we know. This one in detail I will show you the picture. In the picture, we'll see the picture.
Yes, ma'am.
You tried in home?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, by cutting the onion, we can see the layers of the earth. It is a concentric circles. Crust, mantle, core. Already we discussed this one. Next one, see, here intersection of the earth. The earth is in a round shape, no? Like this is then of earth. So, I am saying the intersection. Like this, you cut the that is called the intersection of the earth. Now see here, I am showing you two intersections different. This is intersection of the earth. What it shows, how many layers are there?
Three.
Only three layers are there. First one is crust. Next one is?
Mantle.
Mantle. Third core. One is core. In this, only three layers. It is based on?
Earth.
Composition of?
Minerals.
Minerals. The earth layers divided based on the composition of the minerals. Only three layers are there. Crust, mantle, core. Next, this one you observe. This one. It is based on, the layers based on?
Mechanical movement.
Mechanical movement. How many are there? You count. How many layers are there?
One, two, three, four, five.
First layer is? Lithosphere. First layer is?
Lithosphere.
What is the second layer?
Asthenosphere.
Next, third layer?
Mesosphere.
Next layer?
Outer core.
Next one?
Inner core.
Inner core. You observe this one? Layers based on the movement?
Yes.
Mechanical? Okay. You can do in home also. This one easy to do. You can easily understand. By this means easily you can understand. So one more way, also see in a easy you can understand here in this figure. See the same earth, the shape of the earth, I divide into two parts I divided. See in the first part, this is the part 1. This is the part 2. In the part 1, based on the
chemical composition.
Chemical. So here chemical composition based on the chemical composition. How? See here already we discussed. First layer is called the solid one is called the crust. Solid one is called the
crust.
Here. See here. This crust here, see here thickness is more. Here thickness is less, thickness is more. So this is the which crust?
Oceanic crust.
Oceanic crust. This is the
continental crust.
Thickness is more. This is the oceanic crust. This is the continental crust. Next crust of the
mantle. Mantle.
Mantle. The thickness of the mantle. This is the thickness of the mantle. Next third layer, which layer is there here?
Core.
Core. This third layer is the core. Okay. Now we see the part 2. Here based on the chemical composition, three layers we discussed, crust, mantle, core. Now based on the mechanical composition means movement of the layers. Movement of the layers. Already how many layers we told? This is the first layer. This is the second layer. This is the third layer. This is the fourth layer. This is the fifth layer. How many layers can you observe here?
Five.
First layer, second layer, third one, fourth one, fifth one. See here, first layer. Already we discussed about the first layer. See here, first layer. Here in the first layer. Now see in the first layer. Here, crust plus upper mantle also added. Crust plus upper mantle. This sphere is, what this sphere is called?
Lithosphere.
This sphere is called lithosphere. This sphere is called lithosphere. Means crust plus upper mantle. Crust plus upper mantle. See here, this part, mantle also added here. This is mantle actually, this part also added here. In this. Next one, second one we see. What is the second sphere?
Asthenosphere.
Next one see here, first one lithosphere, it is very rigid and floats. It floats on the here. Because in the lower mantle, liquid is there. Already we discussed. Magma is there here. It is floating. It is floating, moving. So on that this layer will float. This layer will float. Now lithosphere you see 10 to 200 kilometers. It, the distance is 10 to 200 thickness is. Next one is 660. Next sphere is 660. Now third one you see, what is the third one?
Mesosphere.
Mesosphere. This also rigid. This also rigid. Next one you see here, fourth one is the outer core. It consists liquid form. Magma. It consists of the things of liquid form. Next fifth one see inner core. Again it is in a solid state. The inner core is in a solid state. Here we can get this mineral is nickel ferrous. Nickel and ferrous. Ferrous means iron. Ferrous means iron. Nickel and ferrous they are available. Now see here also same picture I shown here. Same one, this one also. So here the outer layers is crust mantle core. Crust mantle core. Here the based on the mechanical composition. Based on the mechanical. What is this sphere?
Lithosphere.
Next sphere?
Asthenosphere.
Next sphere?
Mesosphere.
Next sphere?
Outer crust.
Next one?
Outer core and inner core.
Outer core and
inner core.
Here mesosphere we are saying now. Don't confuse this one. Mesosphere. Why it means? Again, in the atmosphere we get it mesosphere. In atmosphere also layers of atmosphere will get mesosphere. That mesosphere is different. This mesosphere is different. That is above the earth. In the atmosphere we are discussing. This mesosphere below the earth. Down of the earth. In the layers of the earth we are discussing about this mesosphere. You don't confuse. Okay. Now we will once again revise this one. What we have discussed. So we discussed today about the layers of the earth. Based on the chemical composition, based on the mechanical, the physical behavior, based on